हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू ऑनलाइन क्लासेस विद AK. इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट प्रेजेंट इंडेफिनिट टेंस. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सम अफर्मेटिव सेंटेंसेस दैट रिलेटेड टू सम हैबिट्स एंड रूटीन्स, परमानेंट सिचुएशंस, फैक्ट, स्टेट्स. फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस हैबिट्स एंड रूटीन्स. वी विल सी द फर्स्ट सेंटेंस, आई ड्रिंक टी एवरी मॉर्निंग. दिस सेंटेंस is used here as habit. It means when he get up early in the morning, that time he need tea. So we can say it is a habit. Now we will see the second sentence. Sonu visits his parents on weekends. He visits his parents on weekends. It is a routine. Here the first sentence is used as habit and the second is used as routine. Now we will see about permanent situation. We will see first sentence, my brother live in America. He live there permanent. So we can say it is a permanent situation. And second sentence, he speaks English. And it also a permanent situation. And the third sentence, I work as a teacher. And this sentence is not used as a temporary. This sentence is used as a permanent. So we can say permanent situation. Now we will see the next point, that is fact. We will see the first sentence, the capital of India is New Delhi. So it is a fact. Now we will see the second sentence, water boils at 100 degree Celsius. And it is also a fact. Now we will see the third sentence, 2 plus 2 equals 4. If we will add 2 plus 2, then always it will come 4. It is also a fact. And we can say these all sentences related to facts. Now we will discuss next point, that is state and state verbs. And here sentences, I want ice cream. And here this sentence is used as state, or we can say state verb is used here in this sentence. Whenever we will use such sentence, we will use as a present indefinite. We can't say or we can't use such sentence as I wanting ice cream. The use of correct or right sentence is I want ice cream. And we will make such sentence in present indefinite only. We have discussed about some points like habits and routines, permanent situations, fact, and state or state verbs. I hope you understood about these points. And now we are going to discuss deeply about present indefinite tense. By seeing this story, you will better understand about present indefinite tense. Here is a man. His name is Alex. Alex is a bus driver. But now he is in bed, asleep. So he is not driving a bus in this time. In this time, what he is doing? He is asleep. But he drives a bus. He is a bus driver. To make you understand, I will tell you some more sentence. You go to school. You get up early in the morning. These all sentence belongs to present indefinite tense. Words fly in the sky. Earth moves around the sun. These all sentences used as habits and routines or permanent situations, fact or states. Or we can say these all sentence belongs to present indefinite tense. Some other things we will see related to present indefinite tense. Here some verb is written, drive, work, do, etc. These all belongs to present indefinite tense. In present indefinite tense, if the subject is used, I, we, you, they, then be used as verb first form only. Then if the subject is used, he, see it, then be used verb first form, then with the verb, we use as or es. Then our sentence comes, he, drives, see, works, it, does. Now we will see these affirmative sentences. First, nurses look after patients in hospital. Second, I usually go away at weekends. Third, the earth goes around the sun. Remember that when we will use as a subject, he, see, it, that time with the verb, we have to use as or es. Don't forget to put as or es with the verb. Suppose I work, but we will say he works. They teach, but we will say my sister teaches. Don't forget to put as or es with the verb. We use the present indefinite tense to talk about things in general. We are not thinking only about now. We use it to say that something happens all the time or repeatedly, or that something is true in general. It is not important whether the action is happening at the time of speaking. Now we will see the interrogative and negative sentences. In interrogative sentence, we use do, does plus subject plus verb first form. And in negative sentence, we use subject plus do, does plus not plus verb first form. We will see this conversation. I came from Canada. Where do you come from? Would you like a chocolate? No, thanks. I don't eat. Now we will see the first sentence. I don't get up at 8 o'clock every morning. It is a negative sentence. We will see the second sentence. Arun does not drink tea very often. This also a negative sentence. We will see third sentence. Do we go to school? It is a interrogative sentence. We will see fourth sentence. Does he teach us? It also an interrogative sentence. And here is some work for you. Complete the sentences using one of the following verb. And here the second portion, do as directed. Here the sentence is given. And the back side of the sentence in bracket there is written negative interrogative. So you have to change the following sentences as directed. Thank you for watching this video. Like and subscribe my channel so you will get latest notification. Okay, bye. Then see you in the next class.